Hey, everybody. Thanks for coming back to Stamping School. It's March 27th, 2021, and I was going through my retiring list for Stampin' Up, and I found a stamp set that I hadn't even used yet. Shame on me. So I wanted to make sure I got to use it before it retired. So these will be retired before the annual catalog comes out May 4th, 2021. And it's just one of those fun watercolor-looking stamp sets that you can create these fun scenes with throughout the different seasons. And we also got a sneak peek of that annual catalog coming out May 4th. And demonstrators can go online and look at it now, early. And there was a sample toward the back of the catalog that had a white frame that with mitered corners like this. And I thought, well, that'd be kind of fun to try. So I'm going to show you my tips for getting those mitered corners to make your own little framed artwork like that. Now, this set is photopolymer, and they're going to be making some changes to the photopolymer stamp sets coming out in the new catalog. We normally get a sheet like this that's printed, and we put the photopolymer stamps on it, and we can peel them on and off. They're going to change that so that, and this is how I think they're going to look, this piece of paper inside here will come around, and this, the images are going to be printed on the actual paper, so it'll look like this behind here. And then you will put your stamps directly into the case. So what that does is it saves resources because they don't have to have another printing job on this as well as this. And I am really gonna miss it because I tell you, I use it all the time when I'm trying to line up things, you know, and see what fits where and how to do things. So what I'll probably do is I'll probably just stamp these on vellum, or I'll make a copy of this on the vellum so I can keep it in the stamp case and use it in the same way and kind of line things up. So it's one of the perks to save resources, and I totally understand. It's good to save the planet any way we can. But this stamp set is really fun to build little scenes. So to make your little mini artwork and to get this frame lined up around it, what I found was you need two pieces of paper. One is going to be for the actual artwork, and one is going to be your outside frame template that we're going to build the frame with. So this one is 2.5 by 3.75, and this one is 3.25 by 4.5, and they will layer together, and I'll show you how that looks. We're going to start by doing our little artwork first. So this requires a lot of ink colors because you're using so many different ones. So if you're going to be doing these for classes, I know a lot of demonstrators watch my channel. They do still have the Stampin' little spots, and these would be great because they're small, and all these stamps are fairly small, and you would just need like espresso or something for the larger things. But like the little group of spots are still available. I think this grouping is $24. I don't know if it's carrying over in the new catalog or not, but, and a lot of people have the little spots from the paper pumpkin kits that they've saved. The other thing is, if you're getting all of these ink pads out to do at least 2 or 3 cards so you can stamp. For instance, we're gonna stamp this little brook or this little river here first in balmy blue. And if you do that, if you're going to have to change blocks a lot and do all that, then you can just stamp several at a time. Oh, look what I did. Well, I'll cover that up with a tree. So one thing is that you can, you know, stamp all of those as you're going along and then clean and then move on, because this is a lot of blocks and a lot of colors. So that's balmy blue. I'm doing the little bridge next in soft suede, and I'm going to do that so I know where to put my grass. So I kind of have a registration for when to do that. Pear pizzazz for the grassy green, and this is meant to be artistic, okay? So you are not going to get this perfectly aligned with the brook. See, there's gonna be little spaces in between, and that's where I really love to use these registrations, because I can come around with it and kind of see what fits where, you know, and do it that way. But I'm just sort of getting it in there and guessing and keeping it kind of loose and fun. I'm not trying to be perfect, even though I want to be. I'm going to use the opposite side over here and get these lined up. And I need a little bit more right here to connect the bridge. There. So there it is. And now I have two smudges I have to cover up. Next is early espresso, and this row of trees. I'm only going to use 3 of the trees because I don't want to overwhelm this little artwork here. So we're just doing three. And while I have the early espresso, I'm going to do the little birds. I'm going to do those right about there. First time I did this, my birds were flying upside down. So fixed it this time. All right, back to the balmy blue, and I'm going to add some clouds. Let's do one here and maybe one over here. This part I'm kind of leaving open so that I can add my little greeting. So I got a little extra space over here I'm going to leave. All right. Then old olive, and I'm going to do the little tiny trees. And the key is tap very, very lightly so you don't get ink all over this, or you'll get those little guys. You'll get little blotches. So we're just going to stamp a few of these trees, and then just a little bit in the background, kind of stamping off. I'm going to go a little lower, see if I can cover up that blue. There we go. There's the olive. And then my greenery. I've got some little tulip stems here and some tiny little grass. So I'm going to do a little, let's see, we'll do one here and a little one down here. And then little bitty teeny grass. And this is where, oh my goodness, you can go crazy if you lose these little guys because they're clear. So just be careful when you clean them that you don't lose them. My little red tulips right here. I just like that little pop of red. And my card base is going to be red, so that will be the rule of three. One, two, three on the red. If you want to get one more ink pad and do yellow, you can, but it's so tiny. I'm just going to take my blends or a yellow marker, any marker will work, and I'm just going to add my own little splashes of yellow in there because it's just too much to get out one more ink pad. And that's the little scene. Now, this has a little bit of blue in the sky instead of just leaving it white, and so I did my old trick of my Stampin' Spritzer, alcohol in here, and then some drops of balmy blue. And so I'm just going to spritz it and get rid of everything. I'm just going to do a quick little spritz, just enough to give a little blue haze to the sky, which you can see when you put it here. All right, so that's done. It'll take longer to get out all the ink pads and put them all away than it does to stamp it. So, but I really like the little scene. I think it's sweet. And I also like doing it on a smaller piece because by framing it out, it makes it stand out and you don't have to create this big scene. We could add hills and we could add the large tree. We could add the wagon. We could do the gazebo. I mean, we can make a huge scene, but it is nice to keep it small. Now this gets glued to the larger piece of white to make our frame. Get it as good in the center as you can. Nice and straight. Okay, so now it's layered on there. Now we're going to take our wood grain paper. This is from that Tasteful Textiles, I think. And I don't believe it's retiring. I think it's going to carry over. So, but wood grain paper, any kind of wood grain paper you have, just make sure that your strips are the same width. That's important. So I've got two of them, and I'm just going to cut them in half. So we need four strips like that. So we're going to now build it. Now here's what you need. You need something repositionable. Some people have tape like this. Mono Adhesive makes it, different companies make it, and it's repositionable, or your Zig glue pen, that's a two-way glue pen that we used to carry. I don't have those anymore, but I did have this matte finish removable tape. You have to have it because when those corners come together and we miter them, they move around. So I'll show you how to do that. But I have this handy, and we're going to put a little bit right in, just in the center, and avoid the ends because we have to get up in there and snip. And this is where this edge really helps. We're going to line up these half-inch strips with the bottom and edges, okay, right along the edges. So it's going to cover your artwork just a little bit, but it gives you something to straighten it on. So I could have brought my tulips up just a wee bit. So kind of keep that in mind when you're stamping. This will cover up a little bit, but it's kind of nice that it goes off the canvas too. Then we'll go around this way. And remember, line it up with the edge so that it's nice and straight. Because it's really easy if you line it up with this, if this is a little off, right? So we're going to just do it, just tape in the center and come around. Oops. And plus that gives that little bit of edge that covers the canvas. Okay, one more. It really doesn't matter what order. You can do the two top or the two sides. You know, I kind of played around with it. It didn't seem to make a difference. So the corners are going to be mitered. Now, this is what we have to do. Because we left those corners blank, we need to come in and cut like this on both those edges. But these will move around. And when I was doing it the first time, they were off just a little bit. And I had a little gap. So we don't want that. So you really got to keep them together just a little bit when you cut. Okay, so you're going to just tape those two pieces together. Just enough to hold it down. Slide your scissors in so you're cutting above your mat that's in there. See my scissors poking through? All right, so you need to just cut from corner to corner as straight as you can, like that, and then pull that away. And then you have your mitered corner. And we'll come back and we'll glue these back together again. So we can just kind of sneak in here. And I found it was easier to use a liquid glue to kind of sneak in and put just a touch of glue in rather than trying to get this tape dispenser in. So you can just come in and just put just a wee dot in there on each side. Just there. You don't want too much that it oozes through the seams. And I can really pretty much use the same tape on this one and just work my way around and cut all of my mitered corners. Isn't that fun? All right, so here's your mitered corners. Now, to make it nice and accentuated, what I did is I took one of my markers. Now, I use the dark smoky slate, but you can use anything you like. You can use a regular marker, whatever, but I like the way this kind of blends into the corners. Under each one, like a shadow, right along the seam, just add a little bit of the marker. And what that does, it just says, hey, look at me, I'm a mitered corner. Look at all the work I did. It sort of points it out that you did something special on that. Now, if you have a few corners that don't line up, I don't know if you can see this or not. See that little bit right here? You just trim it off. Or at the very end, which is what I did on this one, at the very end, I needed to shave off just a wee bit. If you have a guillotine cutter, that works great to just shave off and make sure that all of these are nice and even. Now for the card base, I tried all kinds of different colors, everything from crumb cake to Sahara sand to gray granite. I mean, I tried all sorts of things, and you know what looked the best was white. I mean, everything that I went with was not snappy enough. So you can make your own beadboard like I did here. So I just scored two skinnies and a wide. So little eighth inch and then a half inch. So I just kind of scored with my scoring tool. Or you can use the Suttles embossing folder. That would look great too. It's got that great texture on it and it's retiring. So make sure you get it because this is a staple in my stamp room. I use it all the time. I'm sad it's going. So I decided this time I would use the beadboard so it looks like wall paneling. And I'm gonna, this one I actually put up on Stampin' Dimensionals. I put on the strips. This one I'm gonna mount directly to it and see how that looks. So I think these little mini artworks are fun. And you could just stamp your sentiment directly on it if you want to. Right here, or you could put a little banner. I'm using the itty bitties, and let me tell you, these, all the itty bitties are going. They are on the retiring list, and I'm never getting rid of them because they are such staples too. I love the itty bitties. So Itty Bitty Greetings has two stamp sets in it, okay? And then the Itty Bitty Birthdays and the Itty Bitty Christmas. I love them all. They're just great to add just that little bit. So we're going to do Itty Bitty Greetings. And we're doing this Hey Friend, which I love. I've used it to pieces. And I just cut it out with a little circle. And again, it's following that same template, that same idea that I saw in the new annual catalog. When you get it, you'll see it's toward the back of the catalog. So, and then I just needed some ribbon. This is the one that's on the retiring list. It comes in a pack of two. It's the Ornate Garden. It's $3 right now. It's on sale, clearance, $3, and you get 5 yards on each spool. So we're gonna do the old olive, and you need about 5 inches of it. And we're just gonna put it together. Just put a little bit of glue right there, kind of click it over there, and add this with dimensionals right there. So I'm gonna turn this over and put some dimensionals on there to hold that ribbon down. There you go. And then we'll trim that off. And it just gives a nice little something something without being overwhelming, because, you know, we don't want to overwhelm all the artwork we just did. We just made this really cute scene and we don't want to take away from that. So just making a little banner here. It says, hey, friend. Isn't that sweet? Or you can just do nothing. You don't have to have anything on it, but it's just kind of pretty. Let me show you what I did on the inside. Now, this one, you can see how much shorter it is. I made my card shorter because this ended up being more square and I had to move it all in. And I like this framed out better. It balances much better, but I do like this standing up better. So you decide. Here's the inside, just a swash of that green and that cute little wheelbarrow, which is why I bought this stamp set in the first place, because I love that cute little wheelbarrow. You can stamp this in espresso. I did that in red, and then my little flowers that are in there. So that's it. Thanks for watching. I love it when you guys leave me comments and tell me what you think. And thanks for subscribing and following me. I really appreciate you guys. All right, we'll see you next time. See it, learn it, stamp it.